Welcome to War India News Hour. Web 3.0, a $1.1 trillion growth opportunity for India. Web 3.0 envisions a decentralized future where users and machines are able to interact with data via smart digital contracts over peer-to-peer networks without the need for big tech. Digital assets like Bitcoin, Ether, Solana, etc. are the fuel of future financial ecosystem and Web 3.0. According to the report by crypto and digital asset exchange Cross Tower in partnership with US-India Strategic Partnership Forum, the digital asset economy's value to India's GDP will grow at 43.1% CAGR from $5.1 billion in 2021 to $261.8 billion over an 11 years period, resulting in a $1.1 trillion contribution to the India's GDP. Digital asset market capitalization was nearly $1.5 billion in 2013 and stands at about $3 trillion today, as per the reports. Most of the $1.1 trillion in the total economic growth in the next 11 years can come from ancillary digital asset related businesses that are yet to be invented. India is poised for growth to become a $5 trillion economy by 2024 to 2025. Digital assets are expected to have tremendous potential in the next 11 years across countries due to their rapid adoption. They are expected to help India achieve the $5 trillion economy goal. According to the findings, the adoption rate of digital assets, that is, as reflected by accounts opened on centralized cryptocurrency exchanges, is growing nearly twice as fast as that of the internet. It took the internet approximately 7.5 years to go from around 100 million users to 1 billion users. The same growth at cryptocurrency exchanges will take about 4 years. From digital art to ticket sales, music, collectibles, luxury items and games, non-fungible tokens could transform the way people interact day to day. While still nascent, NFTs are projected to emerge into a market of $1 trillion or more. The report mentioned, with the high policies and regulatory framework, India's regulators can bring safety combined with hope and prosperity to India, said Kapil Rathi, co-founder and CEO Cross Tower. The government-related blockchain projects are estimated to drive close to $0.1 billion of GDP to India in 2021, ramping up to $5.1 billion in 2032. Finally, the report projected that digital identity could contribute $8.2 billion to India's GDP in 2032. Let's look into today's headlines in War India. General Bipin Rawat and wife Madhulika to be cremated in Delhi. General Bipin Rawat, Chief of Defence Staff, was on a visit to Defence Services Staff College, Wellington, Nilgiri Hills, to address the faculty and student officers of the staff course. General Rawat, India's first Chief of Defence Staff, was among 13 people killed in a helicopter crash near Kunur in Tamil Nadu, shocking the country's three services, setting back the country's military reforms and leaving a direct impact on the country's military establishment. President Ram Nath Kovind, Prime Minister Narendra Modi and others expressed anguish over the sudden demise of CDS General Bipin Rawat, his wife and 11 other defence personnel in a chopper crash on Wednesday. The cremation ceremony of General Bipin Rawat and his wife Madhulika Rawat will be held in Delhi Cantonment on Friday. Visa launches crypto advisory practice. Visa said it is launching an advisory practice to help clients navigate the world of cryptocurrencies. The payments processor hopes it can help further mainstream adoption of Bitcoin and other digital currencies. Visa further says that its crypto advisory practice, housed within its consulting and analytics division, will offer advice to financial institutions, retailers and other firms on everything from rolling out crypto features to exploring non-fungible tokens. Visa named American bank UMB as a client that's already using its crypto advisory services. France's Lydia raises $100 million to help it build out its financial super app. French startup Lydia becomes the second most downloaded fintech app in France, allowing 5.5 million customers to bank, invest and send money to each other. Giant investors like Tencent and Axel are also Lydia supporters, joining its 133 million Series B. Tencent, Axel, Founders Future, Dragoneer and EcoStreet joined the latest funding round for Lydia, which claims 5.5 million users. With this, Lydia becomes a unicorn, having been valued at over $1 billion in a new $100 million round, flanked by US funds Dragoneer and EcoStreet. Lydia's most ambitious target is to become a financial super app for millennials and Gen Z. With the new funding in place, Lydia sees its plan to hire 800 people over the next 3 years as it seeks to hit 10 million customers across Europe. India to impose ban on crypto payments, deadline for declaring crypto assets KYC rules. The Indian government has reportedly proposed banning the use of cryptocurrency for payments and setting a deadline for investors to declare their crypto holdings. Violators may be arrested without a warrant and held without bail. In addition, the crypto bill may call for a uniform Know Your Customer, that is KYC process for all crypto exchanges. The Cryptocurrency and Regulation of the Official Digital Currency Bill 2021 is awaiting introduction during the current winter session, even as Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman said in Parliament that the government has no proposal to recognize Bitcoin as a currency in the country. The new cryptocurrency bill probably seeks to create a regulatory framework for transactions. It is possible that the government may come up with its own central bank digital currency or CBDC. Microsoft launches Azure Availability Zones in its Central India data center region. Microsoft India announced the launch of Availability Zones in its Central India data center region, providing additional resilience options for cloud customers into cloud applications. Azure Availability Zones allow businesses to spread their infrastructure and applications across dispersed data centers, delivering additional protection and isolation from localized failures, which can range from mechanical or electrical issues, structure fires or flooding, or any unforeseen disasters. They also provide access to mission-critical application data and services to every Azure customer to support their most important workloads and processes. That's all for now. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to VAR India News Magazine. You can download the VAR India app from Google Play Store and Apple App Store for the latest news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.